Hello, hier Eric vom Laserscanning TV, vom Company Laserscanning Europe. We have the November 2020 and we have news to hardware, software, some site information. If you like to be informed what's new on the market, then follow this episode. So, back. We have hardware. In the hardware market, I think the biggest hardware announcement, biggest, the only one coming from Faro, and they released now the they call him the 6 probe or the 6DOF probe. Gives you 6 degrees freedom in measurement. I don't know if you're familiar with laser trackers. Laser trackers, single point measurement system, measure one point, and very accurate over long distance. And but if you like to measure like an engine from a ship, then you have also the cylinder holes, and with these, they measure, they show you this here, mostly to mini prison, and you don't can go with the mini prison. If the tracker follow you, you won't go in the hole, they don't can go then inside, and then you use this probe, what you see here, like as a needle, and then you can take this one and can measure points in some holes or areas what you not can see with the tracker direct from this position, and this gives you more option for you, save time, also good information for Faro customers which have the Faro Vantage S6 or E6 series. Next one, it's dot product. It's handheld scanner, we see it here. It's I had also a conversation with referral from dot product. They announced now the version 4. And the version 4, they supported also the new cameras from RealSense, the L515 and the RealSense depth camera 455. That's for indoor-outdoor applications, and the newer sensors give you better option for measure, also better results. Okay. And they have also the scan and time and the annotation and the multi-measurements. In the software supported now. And on the other hand, we have a newbie on the block, PIX4D. Maybe some people know it. PIX4D is original coming from photogrammetry software, coming original from, founded by Dr. Strecher, is I think the name was a German. It's now Swiss located, and original they make software for UAV systems, also for photogrammetry from UAV and drone application, and now they bring the PIX4D catch solution where they can, I can show you this, maybe do a little bit the same like the product does it. You can use the internal LiDAR sensor from the Apple systems like the new iPhone or the iPad Pro with the internal LiDAR sensor, and generate there also photogrammetry and laser application. And the difference, I think, is you have it here to upload to a server, and the dot product, they can use it, then make the processing on your devices. And I think it's the difference is the dot product stuff, I think they're using the Intel sensors, and they may be better for scanning as the internal sensor from the system from the iPad. Other information, Teledyne Optic, producer for long-range laser scanners, mobile mapping systems and aerial mapping systems, launched a new service center in Europe. It will be located in the Netherlands, and all European customers. They can be used all devices like the Airborne, the Galaxy series, mobile, the Lynx and the Maverick, and terrestrial scanner from the Polaris. That can be serviced there in the Netherlands. Very good. Like, I think it's the east part from Netherlands. Like, if you are sitting in west of Germany, close way, it's only an hour. Very good information for Optec customers. Then I give here some site information. I find this interest. I figured this out in the net. Here's some Japanese company, Otocomp. They try to develop a laser which can scan holes. Where I spoke to the probe from Faro, it's every time problem to measure some holes with laser optical scanners, and they try to develop a special laser who can look inside of like hidden areas, holes, and measure this. I think it's under development. There is big capital, and maybe they bring a good solution in the future. And also another interesting system is Cascade Vision, also from Metrology market. They try to reach this problem, what we can see here, that you have a bigger area is where you need low information, then you have some small areas where you need higher resolution, and they try it with their application that they can do both, that they can have scanning a bigger area and then they can scan some small areas too. Okay, from this information. Then moving to software, Autodesk, they developed, they had in this Autodesk user conference, this year was digital, and they announced that they brings Tandem, Autodesk Tandem, and this is a software solution where you can use real-time your BIM model, like your Revit model or another model, and you can use there some data what you measure from in the field from your systems. Like if you see here, you have in technical building equipment and you get some information about your pumps or I don't know, the temperature of your water, then you can put this everything together in one system and have it in control. That is like a solution for the digital twin. And then another, on the other hand, Autodesk announced also that they acquire these Norwegian company, call them Spacemaker. And the idea behind Spacemakers is that they at first they use artificial intelligence for design purposes in like for architectural AC market. I think I move here a little bit in the video and you can see it. They figure out an easy way where you can make sketches and you can give you find ideas. But on the other hand, you also have some regulation, maybe from the government, what is allowed to build. And they can, then you have these in the computer system, you can give your information inside and the software try to figure out maybe the best solution for developing housing there. I think it's, and they are the first, or I know not the first, but one of the biggest who use these AI, artificial intelligence process. Then we move to the other hand. Faro launched the WebShare software enterprise feature. WebShare is a web viewer for scan data from Faro scanners. And this enterprise version allowed bigger companies, or I don't know who it is, the government, that they have now, they can store the data on their own server, like as an internal IT infrastructure, don't have to go external. And you are take control over your data, and this also a very powerful tool. Then on the next, we have also American company Verisoft, and they announced that they are now support Faro Arms. Verisoft is a newer vendor on the market for metrology software, and they supported different systems, and now also the Faro Arms. And then we move next to site information. This was what I figure out. I find this interesting. This General Motors announced that the new Factory Zero, I think they built one factory new for $2.2 billion. This is the first US plane what get installed the 5G technology. It may be interesting for some people. They are working in scanning digital twin or digital model stuff. Okay. And the last one, that is more interesting to the Germans, where I am. We see that our machinery tool industry, what is a big industry, I think is one of the largest industry on site of automotive industry, they have a big increase in order entry for 2019. We see here it's going down in the debt, like the first shutdown, we had the same lowest level like the financial crisis, and we see it's going down, and hopefully next year it will be starting that the curves starting to increase again, also that we have more orders coming. That's also what I can from our own experience from the last months. I can see that our request from industry customer goes really down. We have more customers from AC market, government, university, but industry, really we have lower request for presentation, purchasing instruments and all this stuff. Also that we see here, this what is my feeling for the German market, and we hope for the better future. If you like this show, my information, then give me a thumb up and also subscribe to the channel. You know, like YouTube is working. If you like to be here on the channel to get every time the newest information from the market. Bye bye, Eric.